In this tutorial, we will be iterating on the spark effect we created in the last tutorial, which is linked in the description. We will be going over how to create and use templates, as well as how to make them generic and expose specific properties. The reason we want generic templates is because they are much easier to use when making multiple instances of the same effect. Exposing the properties of these templates lets us change them for each individual instance, as well as making the property more convenient to control since we do not have to click through several layer graphs in order to reach it. To start, open the spark effect from the last tutorial and select all of the nodes connected to the root node and group them. Right-click and select Group or press Ctrl G. Name the subgroup Sparks Template or something similar. You can see that the Sparks template and all of its components are displayed in the layer panel. The layer panel is split into two sections. The bottom section is where the templates local to the effect are stored, while the top section is where the instances of the template you place in the node graph appear. Select the Sparks template in the bottom section of the layer panel, and in the Properties panel, change the class type to Event. Class type is a property that colors the nodes according to their types so that they can be easily identified. Now that we have that generic template, we can reuse it easily. An easy example to show this is by using an event delay node to run two instances one after another. That node will delay the input event by the amount of seconds specified in the Properties panel. Let's disable the loop function of the particle system. Now, the system will only cycle through once after the restart button is pressed. Create an event delay node attached to the root event, and in the Properties panel, under Event, change the delay value to 1. Then, create a Sparks template node and link it to the event delay node. Now, the effect should appear twice, once right after the restart button is pressed, and once after a 1 second delay. The nodes that are currently displaying in the viewport will light up and then turn off once they have finished. We will cover events in more detail in another tutorial. Moving on, delete the event delay and linked Sparks template nodes, and enable the loop function once again. We've made several different groups within our Sparks template which can make accessing certain properties like color and life time-consuming. To make it easier to control those properties without diving into the Sparks template, you can expose them all the way to the top parent layer. Double-click the remaining Sparks template node. You will see an input node labeled Spawn. It is automatically created by the editor when a template is formed to ensure that the template receives the correct input from the rest of the effect. Double-click the Lines node, then double-click the Sparks Color template. We want to change the color of our sparks easily instead of having to tweak it by double-clicking through all of the layer graphs to access it. The color of our particles is controlled by a color curve which cannot be changed as easily. In order to make changing the color of the sparks more efficient, we will add a tint to our sparks by scaling our color curves. First, add a multiplier node in between the curve over time node and the value output node. Then, create and link a float 4 to the multiplier node. This will be our scaling factor. By default, it is not intuitive to change the color of the float 4, so in the Properties panel, under Semantic, select Color. The particles will all disappear because the alpha is set to 0 by default. Click the value F4C and then set the alpha to 255. And then select a color for the tint. White will give you the original defined color curve, but black will make the particles invisible. Now we will make this float accessible in the parent graph, which in this case is the lines graph, so that we can change the color of the sparks more conveniently. Right-click on the float 4 and select Export as Property. Name the input name Sparks Color Property or something similar. Go back to the lines graph and select the Sparks Color template. In the Properties panel, under General, you should now see your exported property. You might notice that your particles disappear. If this happens, simply click the Reset button to the left of the input field, and it will revert to the color you set before. In order to expose the Sparks color property to the next parent graph, which in this case is the Sparks template graph, we will have to do something different. Go to the Properties panel and find the Sparks color property, then click the small circle on the right-hand side that reads Auto Export. You will see a yellow tab appear once you have done this in order to indicate that a property has been exposed. If you go back to the Properties panel, you will see that the property is grayed out and can no longer be changed. You'll have to go to the parent graph in order to control it again. You can repeat that process and auto-export the Sparks color property once again so that it is accessible in the root graph. Notice how the lines are colored, but the points are not. This is because we did not expose the Sparks color property for the points. We will do this now. Follow along with the steps that we did before. Once that process is done, we can see that both the lines and the points in the spark effect are the same color. All instances of the Sparks template now have the color property exposed. To demonstrate this, create another Sparks template and link it to the root event. Select the new node and change its color. You should now see two different colored spark effects. Our next step now is to expose the nodes that affect the life of the particles. Let's start by double-clicking the Sparks template node, then double-clicking the lines node, and finally double-clicking the Sparks life node. Exposing the life properties will involve similar steps as before. We will right-click on the minimum value and click Export as Property. Next, we will rename the exported name to MinLife or something similar. Now, we will do the same thing for the maximum value, but rename the exported name to MaxLife. Going back to the lines graph, with our Sparks life node selected, in the Properties panel, we now see our two exposed properties, MinLife and MaxLife. Just like with the color property, if the values are set to zero, press the Reset button to the left of the input field. Now, we will auto-export the properties all the way to the root graph as we did with the color property. We must remember to repeat this process once again for the points as well. Once this is done, you can test out different values to see how they affect the particle system. Other properties can be exposed by following the same steps as described previously. If you would like to use this template in other effects, you will see that it is unavailable. In order to solve this issue, we must go back to the effect in which the original template was created. Then, with the Sparks template selected, in the Properties panel, check the Public box. This will make the template available across all of your effects within that Popcorn Effects project. To test this, go back to the editor, create an empty effect, and name it Test. Then, create and link your Sparks template node just like you would any other node. It is important to note that the effect will only be available in the project so long as the effect in which it was originally created still exists. If you delete this effect, the template is deleted as well because its original definition is only in that effect. Its copies are only instances. If you would like to organize all of your templates in one effect, we advise that you go to the library directory. Make sure you do not save your templates in the Popcorn Effects core directory because your effects could be deleted if the editor is updated. Instead, create a My Custom Templates folder and copy and paste all of your templates there. That's all for today. Thank you for listening and stay tuned for our next tutorial.